Hey guys, and happy day 10. We are a third of the way through the challenge. Can you believe it? It's been a really quick 10 days, it feels like. And it has been so much fun watching all of your lives. And tonight, we're supposed to recap. We're supposed to recap what we've learned and really what we've gotten from the first 10 days. And I'm coming on a little bit earlier than I usually do, I think, tonight because it's Wednesday night. And in our family, Wednesday night means trivia night. We get together with our whole big family, like my parents, my brother, our niece, that kind of thing. And we go to a local restaurant and we play trivia. And we tend to fund our Wednesday night dinners with our winnings from previous trivia nights. So it's a lot of fun. So I am having to jump on early tonight. The way the trivia works, I'm going to take just a quick second and tell you that, and I'll give you my 10-day recap. But I think it's just kind of interesting. The way they work, the trivia thing, is that the people who are regulars, like us, I feel like we're like Cheers, you know, Norm. It's kind of like we're that way. We walk in and everybody knows our team. But anyway, on Wednesdays, you log in to the website that's hosted by this whole big trivia company, and they give you the answer of the night. So one of the, I don't know, 24 questions, something like that, one of the answers they give to you. And so if you know it, you're lucky because it's usually the hardest answer of the night. It's usually a tricky one. So anyway, that's kind of an interesting little tidbit about our life and why I'm starting earlier. The answer tonight is Whitman's Sampler. So of course I see the yellow box, I think the candy, and I was always that person who took the toothpick and put it down in the candies to see what flavor they are, because I don't like when I just take a bite and guess about what the taste is going to be. I'm not a fan of that. So I was always the toothpick person. So, you know, we're in every crowd. I'm that person in my crowd. But anyway, my 10-day recap. This has been a great experience. I've never gotten nervous about the camera. It doesn't bother me. I've been in theater since I was a little girl. And so the stage, the camera, those things are all really comfortable for me. And so that hasn't been a thing. But the thing that has been a thing for me is that I tend to second guess myself when I think about, oh, I should go live about this topic. I say, no, I shouldn't do that. No, that's not good enough. I overanalyze. And so I get what they call analysis paralysis. And just having the prompt of here's what to talk about has been great. Like, you could tell me to talk about anything and I'm happy to go on live and talk about it. But if I'm left to my own devices to figure out a topic, I will put it off and then ultimately not do it. So the biggest thing for the 10-day challenge thus far, the 30-day challenge, the first 10 days of the 30-day challenge, the biggest thing has been just having that prompt and having that guidance of, okay, go talk about this. Even when it's, I don't want to say it's a nothing prompt, but even when it's just a very simple prompt, I would talk myself out of it and say that it's not good enough, or it's not interesting enough, or it's not whatever enough. And so just being given the prompts has been incredibly helpful for me. Now I've got to make it translate over to my business and to my profile, and I'll figure that out. But just having that consistency has been really, really powerful for me. So thank you all who have listened to any of my lives. It's been great, and I've enjoyed listening to yours. I hope y'all have a wonderful night tonight, and go ahead, take your guesses. What will the question be? The answer is Whitman's Sampler. So I'll check in and let you know what it was. Talk to y'all later. Bye.